Dr. Heather here, and as always, thank you very much for subscribing to the channel and taking a look at some of the content that I've provided for all of you. And if you haven't subscribed yet, do go ahead and click the subscribe button. There's a ton of great content on here. I'm big on education because I really want you to understand how to help your body through whatever pain symptoms that are going on, whether they're chronic or acute, or maybe you have some general questions based upon some sports performance activities that you've been doing now that are now leading to some old injuries, some aches and pains, and so forth. And as always, guys, you know, if at any point during the video you're finding some value in the content being provided, always do hit a like button that you do see there as well. And if there's anything particular you would like to see, please do go ahead, drop some comments down below. Always happy to make some videos on other topic areas that you guys seem to be struggling with and would like some different perspective. Okay, so today what I wanna talk to you about is the difference between flexibility and mobility. So we might not know what the difference is between the two unless you are more of an expert in the health and wellness field. So let's kind of just go down the general list in terms of what does Wikipedia define flexibility as. Wikipedia defines flexibility as the ability to flex forward, okay? Mobility is defined by Wikipedia as essentially the ability to move our body through multiple ranges of motion, different planes of motion as well. So when we look at returning from an injury, those are actually two of the two key components that you want to really address before returning to full activity, okay? So this is something I address with all of my patients, whether they're virtual or in person, is the fact that we want to build back up our flexibility, work in our mobility, and then attack the strength. The reason being is once you've kind of had that pain or that discomfort set in, a lot of times what happens is we change our natural biomechanics. We change the way we're gonna do something, do that activity. So, you know, when I talk about biomechanics, a lot of times people think that it's referring to, you know, the way they run, maybe it's the way they actually, you know, hit a ball, whether it's a baseball, a tennis ball, even throwing, you know, the lacrosse ball around, or maybe it's actually doing a specific type of exercise or movement when lifting. So when we look at biomechanics, we really want to understand what exactly is happening with the body from literally the foot all the way down, all the way up, I should say, you know, to that lumbar spine, and then all the way back down. Now the same goes for the upper body as well. So when we're addressing biomechanics, it's very important to understand the relationship up here as well, what's going on in the torso, all the way out to the shoulder girdle in terms of the shoulder blade, the shoulder joint itself, the glenohumeral joint, all the way out down towards the wrist. So when we look at biomechanics, it's very important to not just understand the sport or activity you're going to be returning to, but also looking at the other factors that are going into play in terms of the other activities you may be doing, you know, whether it's at home, doing home workouts, or at the gym. So today what I wanted to really more or less address is those two important factors before you start adding in that strengthening program, which is the flexibility and mobility. So right now, let's take a look at what it means to do flexibility. So when we address the flexibility part, we want to start with the soft tissue. It is very important that we break down the soft tissue in a manner that allows for the joint itself to become more movable and allows for that tissue to become much more flexible. Makes sense, right? So the first thing we want to do is obviously address foam rolling, soft tissue work, whether it's the roller, the massage ball. Maybe if you are going and still getting massage work done, having your massage therapist do a few things as well. So the first step is to go ahead and look at it this way. The second bit is to actually go through a really good stretch program. So if you have a yoga program that you like to follow, anything that's going to be a little bit more not high intensity yoga, I'm not really talking about Bikram yoga and pushing yourself through certain movement patterns, but actually looking at doing some nice gentle stretching to open up those areas. And if you want more stretches, do click on some of my other videos here on the channel regarding some different types of hip stretches you can do. Whether you're a skier or a runner, there are some really great things that you can do there that are some stretches. And if you're experiencing more of that mid-back pain, I have another video regarding mid-back pain where we look at various different types of soft tissue work you can do and regaining some more mobility in that mid-back. So right off the bat, like I said, you want to start with the soft tissue. That's going to help with the flexibility. Then you want to work in those yoga poses and allow for that body to start to become more flexible through gentle stretching. Now, when we talk about mobility, mobility is not necessarily, like I said, going back in and starting to really do the strength aspect, but it's looking at putting our body through ranges of motion through its own body weight. So now, you guys have already heard this name before. I love the TRX just simply because it's a great fitness tool that we can use to help increase that flexibility, but also work in that mobility. So for point examples, I'm going to show you guys what I mean by that by looking at two various types of stretches you can do with the TRX to help with those specific things when it comes to now incorporating the flexibility and starting to work in that mobility. So like I've mentioned, I love the TRX just simply because we can work on the flexibility and the mobility. Here are two stretches that go ahead and do the exact same thing I'm talking about. It's known as a golf swing. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to come into our TRX. The straps are set at mid-length. Our TRX is hung at the proper height. We're going to go ahead, we're going to come in so that the straps are nice and taut. We're going to bend the knees nice and soft, keep the chest out. From here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up to that left side, allowing for full extension of the body, flexing my right knee and going ahead and straightening out my left, allowing for good flexibility and mobility to happen in multiple planes of motion while I'm attacking behind the shoulder girdle. So I'm getting in underneath that scap, I'm getting in towards the QL area, I'm also getting into as well my glute, my hamstring on that left-hand side. So I'm allowing for the body to feel really nice big stretch here in what's called the golf swing. You can modify this stretch a little bit more too by enhancing it by actually looking up and back at that hand, allowing for more increased range of motion and flexibility to happen at that angle. So right off the bat, there's a great flexibility mobility exercise you can do using the TRX, which is known as the golf swing. The next one, which is one that I show in various other videos regarding around hip pain, is actually to do a really nice one that can help open up the hips along with stretching out the psoas, the iliopsoas, and even getting into that QL a little bit more. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna flip ourselves around, we're gonna have our arms straight out in front, we're gonna take a nice big step forward into that lunge stance, come dropping down into that lunge, drop that left arm, reaching up, taking it over, again, allowing for flexibility, mobility to happen in this position, coming in and pushing back up in a nice upright posture. So again, we're coming out, stepping into it, coming out, dropping over, and then coming back. So like I said, guys, when looking at flexibility and mobility, what we want to do is start to really work on those two factors post-injury. So once you're in that chronic phase and you're starting to get ready to go back to that sport, but a little hesitant because you don't want to re-injure yourself, what you really want to do is focus on the flexibility, mobility aspects of the body, use your foam roller, break down the tissue, then look at using things like a TRX after you've done some nice gentle yoga to really work those two together and then apply them into your strength training program. As always, guys, if you found some of this material helpful, please do give it a like. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do go ahead. Like I said, there's some other really great videos regarding hip stretches, things that you can do with the TRX to help increase your own flexibility and mobility. So do take a look at those as well. And guys, as always, you know, make sure you do subscribe to the channel. If you want any more information on how you can incorporate flexibility and mobility, all my subscribers do get a free video consult with me, so please do reach out. I'm happy to kind of give you guys some more guidance and advice on how to increase your overall performance and how to fix your pain naturally through a telehealth platform. So guys, like I said, this is Dr. Heather, really kind of starting to break down and understand flexibility and mobility to a better degree.